Jesus said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. These two commands summarize the entire scriptures.
My husband and I have only been married for a year and a half, and he's Christian, and I find myself in a place where I don't know if I can, you know, honestly say that I am with confidence. And we were really thrilled to discover Christchurch because it was a place where I felt comfortable.
We value questions very highly at Christchurch. We say every week in our service that there is a safe seat for someone who has tons of doubts. There's a safe seat for someone who would not call themselves a Christian. We want them to recognize that Christchurch is a place where they can freely ask their questions.
I started out, you know, I grew up basically not religious at all, was not a churchgoer at all, and kind of had, I think, a lot of misconceptions about the Christian religion and about Christians in general, you know. And I'm still not a churchgoer, but I feel part of this broader community that they've started up, which is, it's really neat.
You know, I think we were searching for community, and it felt like a place where we could experience that.
A lot of people have this impression that religion means the religious right and, you know, religious fundamentalism and all these sort of things that have a very negative connotation here, but I don't think that that's what Christchurch is about at all. I think Christchurch is about community and compassion.
One of the fundamental beliefs of the Christian faith is that God Himself is a community. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity is foundational to the Christian faith. So that's why we value community so highly. We say at the heart of reality is a community, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we're living out of that reality when we gather together in community.
We believe at Christchurch that probably what is innate in every human being, the definition of a human being, is that we are a worshiper.
I think in everything we do, through our prayers, through our music, through our preaching, through celebrating baptism and the Lord's Supper, in all these things, we want to create an opportunity for people to have an encounter with God. We want that for the Christian to be deep and profound and meaningful. We want it to be a communal experience. For the person who's there that's curious or skeptical, investigating who Jesus is and what the Christian faith is all about, we want it to be intelligible to them. We want it to make sense to them.
And they do a very good job of making their services really welcoming to, you know, not just people who are used to going to church, but people that are kind of new to the idea. You know, they have a real kind of a young, hip sensibility. It's not sort of, you know, archaic and stilted. You know, they really are talking to modern concerns and local concerns that matter to people around here.
We try to create space through the service where people can reflect and contemplate and sort of lean into their questions, express their doubts, perhaps even doubt their doubts. But we also have a vehicle we call Curious, which is a community of question asking. We do this 3 or 4 times a year after a service. It's a chance for the pastors at Christchurch to sit down with a handful, usually 10 or 12, sometimes 15 or 16 people, and really listen to their questions. We take topics concerned with Christian faith and practice. We take cultural topics and address concerns and questions that people have.
I think a lot of churches focus inwardly, and it can often get focused inwardly, I think, to a fault. That, you know, that can happen, too much of a good thing. Something I like about Christchurch is that they're part of the community, and that's attractive to me. They not only tolerate the secular world, they're quite interested in it. They respect it. They're curious people.
We wanted early on as a church to be a church that cared about justice. And so we founded this 501c3 Project Peace, which is a desire to take the resources of local churches in the East Bay and bridge them or connect them to many of the needs that social service providers, agencies, and organizations have in our area.
It's really about not just serving ourselves, it's serving the community at large. Whatever their needs are, I think part of what Christ Church is about, it's about reaching out and being a part of the community and serving the people immediately around the church, whether or not they're Christian, whether or not they think favorably about Christians. It's just about extending ourselves outside of our immediate circle.
College Avenue is a Friday night dinner at College Avenue Presbyterian Church. It's been doing for a number of years, and Christ Church Berkeley, our community group, took over one of the Friday nights for them. And it gave us an opportunity to really work up close with people and not sort of at this distance. It's been very meaningful to me in a sense that this was starting out as a service project, and now it's the highlight of my month. I look forward to the fourth Friday of every month so that I can come here and join in this community, not necessarily somebody who's serving, but just being part of this community and get to know the folks that are here as my neighbors.
I want to be part of a church that wants to be part of the world around it and wants to help and pitch in and make things better. And I feel like this is a perfect example. We're not here preaching. We're here resetting locker combinations, moving boxes around, and just pitching in, just simple stuff. And I think that's what a church should do. I think a church should help out. And I think anywhere where there's a church, I think the community around it should be better for it. And that's often not really the case.
You have to, as a Christian, be committed to the words of the kingdom. Jesus said, you know, repent and believe the good news, the kingdom of God is here. But then he also went out and practiced the deeds of the kingdom. He healed the sick, he cleansed the leper, you know, he gathered all the wrong people around his table and said, this is my family, these are my people. So I think the church really has to find a way to articulate the words of the kingdom and then also embody the deeds of the kingdom.
It's not putting on a show. It's there to really welcome everyone, those who believe the things that are being preached and those who don't, and including those who are antagonistic towards what's being preached. They're there to welcome questions, to talk with people about their questions and to work through answers together, and really to be in people's lives as they're going through their questions.
You know, it's no secret that our community in the Bay Area, for the most part, views Christianity not as the solution, but as the problem. And I feel like one of our values and a vision we have for Christ Church is to help change that. I mean, we want people to see through the way we love our community, through the way that we serve those in need, for the way that we fight for justice. We want people to recognize that Christianity might offer hope, that someone who comes to our church and gets involved in a community group or makes a friend who attends Christ Church would walk away understanding that maybe the forgiveness and the redemption and the meaning and the purpose and the satisfaction and the hope that Jesus claimed to bring is relevant for them and might even be for them.